Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. We got Trevor's soon-to-be Drift Week car getting completed up. It was actually supposed to be over at the dyno shop, but he's been working on it. We were over here actually last night looking at some things. He did the heads and cam on it since that last dyno video, and it's coming along. It's getting close. They're finishing up the wrap on it right now, and I'm actually working on the tune. So I got HP tuners in there, my tuning school books in the dash, and I'm just going to try to get a good startup tune, idle tune, and everything while it sits here while they're working on other stuff, and then we can roll it over there, go do some drivability and full throttle stuff on the dyno. So I'm gonna try to get this thing running halfway decent with the startup, and then we're gonna go ahead and move it on over, but just trying to make it happen. I think they're wanting to leave in the morning, and it is right now 6 at night, and I think they want to leave in the morning. So we're a little crunch time here. It's a little dark here in the car, but I got my tuning school checklists. If you guys get the books from them, which I'd recommend. I mean, I went and took the class. That's what helps me. I mean, this is the book that pretty much walks you through everything, as well as this other little book. But working through, so I've went ahead and started on startup changes, idle adjustability, airflow, and spark. So I've already made those changes here, saved it, and now I'm going to go ahead and kick the car on. Write this thing to the ECU, give it a few minutes, and then we'll go ahead and try it and see how well it starts. I was playing with some stuff last night when they were first firing the car. Wasn't quite doing what I wanted, so we need to fire it up, make sure we don't have any major check engine lights or any of that stuff. If you have any check engine lights when you're first trying to start a car, it could throw all sorts of other issues at you, so you got to make sure all of that stuff's working, all the sensors are working, O2s are hooked back up, everything is good to go. It didn't seem to run too bad, so gonna go ahead and play with it here and hopefully get this thing dialed in, at least good startup and idle while we're sitting here still on the lift. So now that I got done riding, you go ahead and key off in a sense. I go ahead and open and close the door. Some GM vehicles are weird with taking the tune. So now I'll go ahead and push the clutch in. Go ahead and try to fire it and see what it does here. It's not bad, but then it died. So we'll play with it and try that one more time. So it still doesn't have enough air. It's close and it wants to stay running, but still not quite enough air to keep it running. So I'm gonna go ahead and add some more in here. That's where like the next step comes in. It says, you know, go to 240 adjust tables and startup changes. And then, so probably need some more airflow in the minimum table. So we're gonna go and try that now. So for instance, here is one of the tables. I'm not sure if you guys can see that very well, but I went ahead and added idle airflow, added, so HP2 is kind of weird. I put 1.2 up here in this box, multiply by, that adds 20%, then interpolate it between bounds, and then that gives us that table. And then I'll come over here to the book, go to the next little section that it talks about, and 240, startup changes. So then startup airflow, add a little there, it'll help the car start up too. So we're gonna go ahead and go through this table, add what they recommend, and then go from there. We're gonna go ahead and write that tune now to the ECU, and give it another try. So that's the only thing that kind of sucks with HP tuners and like stock ECUs, is every time you make a change to the ECU, you got ignition off, make the adjustment, rewrite it, fire it up again. So it's a lot of like trial and error, because you can't just make a change on the fly with the car running, or just back to back real quick. So I'm gonna go and let this thing write. Almost done now, we'll go and try it again. Key off. What? I thought this thing was ready. Well, let's get the mass airflow on it. That's probably why it didn't do worth a crap. Fighting it. Yeah, it'll still work. No, it's all right. It's part of it. Yeah, because I actually failed it to where it's only on mass airflow. So that's probably why it died right away. It probably wasn't too bad.
Oh, there we go.
They got it? Brand new now. Oh, let's try this now. Try some things. Look at some things, try some things. I wonder if it threw some codes now because the mass airflow wasn't in it. No DTCs connect. Alright, try that again. So if I give it a little throttle, it fires right up. So I just need to keep adding until it takes. Alright guys, so the check engine light started blinking. I pulled the code, it does have a random misfire. We kind of went back and forth last night on if it was still down a cylinder or not, and it kind of seems like it is. So we might need to start looking at a few things, trying to figure out what's causing the misfire. Well guys, as you probably saw on Trevor's channel as well, got that misfire code, started looking at things. Last night we had no compression. We checked all the valves, the push rods, a couple of them weren't sitting right, so we thought everything was good there, fired it, had a rough idle, but I was like, no big deal, we'll come back, we'll run it. Well, then as I do some changes, now it's starting to kick the misfire code, go back, look, and he still doesn't have good compression in two of the cylinders, so we got to start diagnosing that and figure out that so we can get past the misfire, then we can continue tuning. All right, everyone, so about 3 hours later.
Hey.
How you doing?
No, actually. I think we're about five.
5 hours from
no,
when
it's,
I...
No, it's actually 4 hours later. Oh, four. It's four.
It's time has passed. And we're figuring that the push rods are a little too long or something in that general idea. So spacers underneath the rockers to...
I'm excited to see the comments.
Oh, man. What a deal.
Like, this is like the sloppy mechanics type stuff. You know, like, I feel like if we asked, like, the sloppy mechanics Facebook group... They would probably.
Oh man, this is like.
They would probably told us to use a Coke can instead of like the V8 energy.
Right,
one,
right. They'd be like, dude, that's 25 thou each, not. Yeah, so it, technically, what, four little energy can pieces of the can is 20 thou, raised the rockers up 20 thou, and now we're getting compression all but one. One's still a little low, right?
Well, we're tuning it in right now.
We're getting it tuned.
Because it was about 145 and we backed it out about like an eighth of a turn, like loosening it up, and then it was like 185, 190.
So how we figured this out is we just torqued the rocker arms all down and then backed them off about an eighth turn and with the like a leak down tester in it, and you could hear it seal up. And then once you put the pressure, like torque back on the rocker arm, it would lose seal. So, yeah. All right, so it's late, and I've been messing with startup, and everybody's been messing with everything, so that's kind of where I'm at. It's still not ideal, but it's even rougher than what it's been doing. So it's just fighting me on startup. It's always a balancing act with timing and everything else. I don't know why it started better the other time, but now there you go. Now it seems like it's starting pretty good. So yeah. I might try a little more timing in it tomorrow after we get everything else dialed in, but things seem to be working okay. So I think I'm gonna call it there for the night. I'm tired of sitting in this vet. I feel like I've sat in there all the way to Houston. We never left the lift. All right, everyone. So that is where I'm gonna end it tonight. Probably won't even see this because, well, it might be in the same video as tomorrow. I don't know. So we'll figure it out. But thanks for watching. All right, everyone. So not quite 24 hours later, back over here. The car is on the ground.
And it looks different now.
It looks different. It looks good. Mean, it's making progress.
Actually, every time you've seen it.
It makes progress between seeing it. That's for sure. You almost ready for your trip?
Great progress. Tremendous progress.
Tremendous. So you're going to leave at 5 today.
5 p.m.
Well, you're going to leave at 5 a.m. and 5 p.m. and
now
then
it's 5:40.
So we're just going in 12-hour variables at this point, right?
We'll just tack on another. So now the new...
What's the new one? Eventually?
Eventually. That's when we'll leave. It's eventually.
We got to figure it out. It's eventually he'll be leaving. So going to just jump in, go over everything again. Now the car's full of fuel. We can go drive it, all that. So we're going to work on some drivability, and then I guess we'll see if we're going to put on the dyno or just give you a good old street tune and send you on your way. So one way or another.
We'll figure it out.
Always put on the dyno, find out what it makes when he gets back if we decide to get
that out. Yeah, if this thing comes back. I mean, I'd like to see some power numbers, but at the same time, I'd like to
get on the road.
Get driving and stuff too, so.
We'll figure it out. All right, we're going to get busy. All right, guys, out cruising this thing, and we're getting down to where the mass airflow is within, you know, 3-5%. So I'll transfer it again, verify, but it'll be within 3% here pretty easily. So we're actually gonna stop by the shop real quick, grab the wide band, and then we can check some wide open throttle stuff real quick. Got everything hooked up, wide band set up, wide band in the car here. Trevi getting the old GoPro getting ready to go. Car's rolling in.
Trying to race or what?
Might as well.
Street two?
Send it.
Yeah.
Getting closer. See where our air fuel's at here. Grip down. What do you got going on there? Oh, little stamp of approval.
Little sticky action.
Oh dang.
What happens when it gets down to Texas and it
don't run right?
Start, but I just go peel off.
yeah. Just build it and race it. You just leave build and then just get your own cut drift.
Build drift.
It's pretty much what you've done. Oh. Right in the middle of your windshield. Well, that'd be dope. A little crooked action. Almost. Got along the... Oh, look at that. You got a lot to place on there. You'll figure it out.
We got a bunch of other ones we're trying to put on here, but the gloss looks pretty good on the matte black.
I do like that. It looks good.
I figured there's no sense in doing matte black without taking advantage of being able to actually put gloss on it and create this effect, you know?
Yep.
Yeah, I'm tired.
So guys, we came over. We got a good base tune-up in it for you to head out with. Saved a couple hours by not putting on the dyno we wanted to. Maybe could have, should have, but it would have just taken more time. We'll get it on there in the future for sure.
I think it would have probably taken the same amount of time. Because then I wouldn't have had to like take you for a drive.
Yeah.
And then you could have just done it.
But, yeah. Well, trying to save you.
Yeah.
We
only have a 13-hour drive.
Yeah. They're down to literally hours, and if they don't make it, then they'd have to be onto the next track and all that crap. So did what we could, got him dialed in pretty well. You'll verify with some logs actually down in Texas, because if we're up here, and they'll whole different deal down there.
Yeah, we'll get her done, though.
Yeah, it looks like you're close.
And she runs good. She rips. She sounds
good. It does good. Yeah, it sounds really good. So it's a cool build. But
yeah, well, I appreciate you coming over and... You know, dealing with me for the past like 4 nights when it was like, oh, hey, it's almost getting ready to dyno, and then it comes over in a giant fiasco of trying to figure out some other stuff. But now we're finally here.
It's close. It's real close.
I seriously thought we were going to be here 3 days ago. Like, I thought it was going to be at this point 3 days ago, and here we are, and it's like, I still need to put a seat in it, and I still need to like load up, pack your stuff on it. And we're like cutting tires off of the wheels because they melted on there. Like,
All the little things.
I don't know what's wrong with me. That's
it's part of it, man. I mean, you gotta do it to get it done, but
it's nuts.
This one was a little rough for sure.
It was rough for everybody, man, and I'm gonna schedule it a little next time.
sounds good, but just events come up and things happen. Yeah. And
well, it's always cool to see what you could do in
100%
in a week, but also at the same time you're like, man, I wish I would have done that in 2 weeks. You know,
everything could be that much more dialed, but there's little things. Well, and I think that's no matter what the build is, you're always going to have, like, things come up.
Yeah.
That you just, like, aren't sure about. But.
Well, we only have, like, 4,000 miles to figure it out.
Yeah, you'll get it dialed in by the end of it, probably. So, actually, I'll be heading to...
We actually might catch each other on the road somewhere.
Yeah, we might see each other. I know we're going to see each other in Florida, but... So, you might do some burnouts with this thing? At Basic
I
Cars,
might,
maybe?
Yeah. I don't know. I'm going to have to figure out how to disconnect the rear brakes.
Not something you haven't done before.
It's not, no. You know what I could do? I should have put a little valve, because I have that hydro e-brake under the console. Put like a little ball valve, just turn the rear brakes off. How you doing?
Yeah.
Burnout car now. Ready
That'll
to
be
go.
Cool. Well, man, you got a lot to do. We all got a lot to do. So, thanks, guys. I know it's kind of a crazy deal, but we came over, we fought through issues, and we got it figured out, and the car runs pretty damn good now. And
oh, yeah, she runs amazing.
Good for you to hopefully Tay can go rip some burnouts, skids, slides, drifts.
All of it. All this car's and then road course stuff, I'm planning on doing it all.
Oh yeah.
With it, so.
All right, guys. Well, I'm sure we'll see more of the vet, but if you want to hit the subscribe button for possibly some upcoming videos of this thing, we'll definitely get it on the dyno.
Oh, yeah.
Do the things. Hit the like button. It's time to go home. See you guys.